trafficking is a very complex issue in the Sahel. It can contribute to conflict. It really needs to be studied and tackled on a case-by-case basis. Trafficking has actually played a stabilizing role in the economy of Northern Niger by creating jobs and providing revenues, and also in the political system by creating avenues for former rebels to integrate into the state, and ways that people were able to offer jobs to former rebels transporting migrants, which was criminalized a couple of years ago. It's important to look to the field and think about how trafficking is perceived on the ground. So this report takes three particular types of trafficking in Northern Niger. We look at the smuggling of migrants, we look at the rise of artisanal gold mining, and we look also at drugs trafficking and how different shocks to each one of these trafficking systems has impacted Northern Niger, and also how the systems in Northern Niger are finding ways to sort of mitigate the violent impact of trafficking, with their overall approach being it's not possible to eliminate trafficking. So the best option in the absence of that is to try to organize and control it in a way that will minimize its violent impact and prevent trafficking from really directly leading to conflict, either between communities or between traffickers themselves. Considering that trafficking can play a stabilizing influence, counterintuitive as that is, it's important to think about the repercussions of criminalizing certain flows such as migrant smuggling and trying to directly combat or eliminate trafficking in the Sahel. And a much more sensible approach is based on two main priorities. First of all, to really develop the formal economy and work with local actors to create more opportunities for young people to have other directions to go in that are not exclusively trafficking. And second of all, to recognize and support the work that's being done by regional actors to mediate and manage trafficking in ways that are both pragmatic and are explicitly seeking to prevent violent conflict. The international community needs to have a more coherent, organized approach to trafficking that shouldn't only be a security approach. And local mediation mechanisms should have more support. And all actors should focus more on developing the formal economy than on trying to get rid of illicit commerce, which is always going to be around.